Afternoon students, now we discuss about the lecture, so that is neutrino hypothesis of beta decay or Pauli predictions of neutrino. In 1930, Pauli proposed a new hypothesis known as neutrino hypothesis. According to this hypothesis, in the process of beta decay, a neutral particle which has negligible mass as compared to electron, charge zero and spin off is emitted along with the beta particles. These particles carries energy and momentum is called neutrino. Neutrino travels with the velocity of light. So that is neutrino resembles with a photon. So when a neutron is converted into proton, an electron and a neutrino are emitted. So the beta decay can be represented by the following equation. So here neutron converted into proton and an electron and neutrino are emitted. So the proton cannot emit which exists inside the nucleus, but electron and neutrino are emitted from the nucleus when neutron converted into proton within the nucleus. Here, so a neutron 0 1 that gives proton 1 1 plus electron -1 0 plus and neutrino. So here mass, so this is the mass 1, so that equal, that is that here that gives, so here mass, proton mass 1 and electron mass negligible, that is 0 plus so neutrino mass is 0. Here the mass of neutrino is equal to equal to the electron mass. So here 1 that equal to 1 plus 0 0 plus that equal to 1. So here 1 is equal to 1. So therefore the mass is conserved. Here charge, so charge of neutrino is 0, that is, so proton charge 1, so electron charge -1, so that is a neutrino charge 0. It is a chargeless particle, so neutral particle. So here 0 is equal to 1 minus 1 plus 0, that equal to 0. Here charge is also conserved. So both the mass and charge are conserved when proton converted into, when neutron converted into proton, so electron and neutrino are emitted. So in this process, both mass and charge are conserved. So the neutrino hypothesis or neutrino theory successfully explains the continuous energy spectrum of beta rays. So in the beta decay, the proton remains in the nucleus while both beta particles and neutrino come out from the nucleus. Already told, so both the particles are emitted simultaneously when neutron converted into proton. So the total energy of these particles is constant and is equal to the end point energy observed in beta ray spectrum as shown in figure here. So this is a continuous spectrum. So the energy is shared between beta particles and neutrino. When neutrino gets no energy, so the beta particles are emitted with maximum energy. So that is end point energy. So seen beta ray spectrum. So this is the end point energy. When neutrino gets no energy, the beta particles are emitted with the maximum energy here. So that energy is known as end point energy. So the energy carried by a neutrino varies continuously by a continuous varying energy of beta particles. So the spectrum is continuous here. In the continuous spectrum, the energy carries of neutrino varies continuously by varying the energy of beta particles. So this represents the continuum. So as the energy of beta particle, as the energy of neutrino particles varies, correspondingly the energy of beta particles are also varying. So this shows, this indicates here the continuous spectrum indicates. So in the lower limit of continuous spectrum, a greater amount of energy is shared by a neutrino than the beta particles. So here in the lower limit, in this region, a greater amount of energy shared by neutron than beta particles. So the problem of conservation of angular momentum is solved by neutrino hypothesis. So in this way, the neutrino hypothesis successfully explains the beta ray spectrum. So thank you, students. Now see the answer from starting to ending. Thank you, students. Please subscribe my channel. Don't forget. Thank you, students. Subscribe my channel.